Hi, Kaylin. I'm Dr. Malloy. I'm a nurse practitioner. Today, we're going to perform a head-to-toe assessment. So, to begin, what's your complete name?
Kaylin Murphy.
And where are you?
Hackensack, New Jersey.
And what's the date today?
June 10th, 2020.
So, you are alert, you're oriented to person, place, and time. I'm going to ask you a few questions to assess your thought processes and your cognitive abilities. What did you have for breakfast this morning?
Cereal.
And how did you get here?
By car.
And if you found a letter that's stamped with a complete mailing address, what are you going to do with it?
Send it to the post office.
Very good. So, I'm assessing your posture. It is erect, your mood is appropriate, you are well-groomed and fully developed, and I see that your speech is clear. So, next, I'm going to palpate your head. Earlier on, I had already taken your vital signs, by the way, and I've also noted your height and your weight. So, I'm going to proceed with the examination of the head. So let me know if this hurts. Does that hurt?
No.
So your head is normocephalic and non-tender. Next, I'm going to palpate your temporal artery for elasticity. Okay. And I'm going to check for sensation. So if you can let me know with your eyes closed what you feel. This is going to be soft. And this is going to be sharp. All right, so what's this one?
Soft, sharp, soft, sharp, soft.
All right, so your sensation is intact. Next, I am going to assess for cranial nerve 7, which is the facial nerve. So if you can raise your eyebrows. Close your eyes real tight, frown, clench your teeth, and puff out your cheeks. Very good. Next, I'm going to examine your eyes. So your eyes look clear. The sclera is white. I don't see any swelling or discharge. So what I'm going to have you do is stand for a moment and read the Snellen chart, which is about 20 feet away. So normally we will have you cover one eye first and then cover the other eye and then with both eyes uncovered, read the lowest line that you're able to read. For the purpose of this demonstration, we'll just have you read with both eyes uncovered. So go ahead and read the lowest line that you're able to.
D-E-F-P-O-T-E-C.
And your visual acuity is 20/20. So you can take a seat. Next, I'm going to assess your visual fields by confrontation. So if you can cover your left eye, and I'm going to cover the same side, which happens to be my right eye. Let me know when you see my finger.
Now. 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 Now.
And I would do the same on the opposite eye. Next, we're going to assess your extraocular motor function. So first, with a cover test. Okay, if you can cover one eye. And I'm just going to inspect your right eye. And then if you can uncover, I'm going to again note for any involuntary movement or nystagmus on the opposite eye. And I don't see any. Next, I'm going to assess extraocular movement. So without moving your head, just following with your gaze, track my finger. And your extraocular movement is intact. Next, I'm going to assess pupillary reaction and accommodation. So just look behind my shoulder. And if you can look at my finger, I'm going to bring this closer to you. Okay. Pupils are equal, they're round, reactive to light and accommodation. Next, I'm going to assess your ear. So first, if you can cover one ear, I'm going to whisper a word and let me know what it is you hear.
Baseball.
Apple. And I would do the same on the opposite ear. If I had any concerns about your hearing or note some loss, I will check for Weber and the Rhine test. So for the Weber, I'm going to put this on top of your head and let me know whether you feel the vibrations equally or only on one side. Do you hear it equally?
Yes.
Next, for the Rhine, I'm going to put this on your mastoid process at the back of your ear. Once you stop hearing it, raise your hand and I can reposition this next to your ear. Do you still hear it?
Yes.
Okay. So earlier on, I should have asked you to say three words that I'm going to tell you, and I will ask about the three words again at the end of the exam. So the three words are apple, balloon, and chair. Can you repeat that for me?
Apple, balloon, chair.
So just remember that. I'll ask at the end. So next, I'm going to assess for cranial nerve 1. If you can close your eyes, I'm going to have you identify an odor, and this is assessing your olfactory nerve. What is the smell?
Lemon.
Lemon. So yes, it is lemon. Okay. Now we're going to move on to the examination of the mouth. So let me put on my gloves. So I'm going to have you open your mouth, and I see that the buccal mucosa is pink and moist. Can you say ah? Okay. And I'm assessing cranial nerves 9 and 10, the uvula rises midline, the tonsils is 1+, and if you can stick out your tongue. Good. And I've assessed cranial nerve number 12. Next, I'm going to palpate your lymph nodes. So this is the preauricular, posterior auricular, occipital, tonsillar, submandibular, submental, superficial cervical, posterior cervical, deep cervical, and supraclavicular. And your lymph nodes are non-palpable, rather. Next, I'm going to assess your trachea and the thyroid gland. So I'm going to have you sip from the cup, and I'm noting your swallowing. I'm just going to palpate at the notch. And if you can tilt your head forward and to the side, I'm just going to palpate your thyroid gland. And then the opposite. Okay. And your thyroid is non-palpable. If your thyroid was enlarged, I would also auscultate for Bruit. So next, I am going to listen to your carotid, and then afterward, I'm going to palpate it. Again, identifying for the presence of Bruit during auscultation. And I'm doing this one side at a time. Next, I'm going to just have you bend your head forward, backward, look to the left, look to the right, and touch your left ear with your left shoulder and your right ear with your right shoulder. I'm now inspecting your thorax. Your breathing is non-labored. I don't see any respiratory effort as manifested by neck retractions, intercostal retractions, and abdominal excursions. So your AP diameter looks less than the transverse diameter, which is normal. So I'm now going to auscultate your lungs from the back. And I want you to breathe in and out deeply. Okay. And I am going to do the same on the front. I'm going to auscultate your lungs. So I have Kaylin laying down so I can perform the cardiovascular examination. So I'm again inspecting his chest, and now I'm going to auscultate for heart sound starting at the aortic region, the pulmonic region, the herbs point, the tricuspid, and the mitral area. And if my stethoscope had both a diaphragm and a bell, I would repeat the process, this time using the bell of my stethoscope. So again, the aortic, which is at the second intercostal space on the right midclavicular line. The pulmonic, which is at the left second intercostal space midclavicular line. The herbs point. The tricuspid, which is at the fourth intercostal space to the left of the sternum, and the mitral, which is at the fifth intercostal space, left midclavicular line. Now I'm going to inspect your abdomen, so I'm noting for any pulsations, any herniations. It is flat. And next, I am going to auscultate for bowel sounds. And I'm working my way around from the right lower quadrant, the right upper quadrant, the left upper quad, and the left lower quad. And I'm also going to lightly palpate, followed by deep palpation. And it is non-tender, bowel sounds are normal active, and I don't feel any masses. Next, I'm just checking your extremities. So for temperature, I don't see any swelling of your arms as well as your legs. I don't see any changes in color. And at this time, I can also check for capillary refill of both the toes and the fingers, and it is brisk. Now I'm going to have you perform range of motion. So if you can raise your arm up, out, behind your head, and behind your back. And I'll do the same on the leg. If you can raise your leg up, out, towards the opposite side, and just bend them at the knee. Very good. And I'm just going to help you sit up, Kaylin. Okay. So, Kaylin, I have you sitting down, and now I'm going to test for your muscle strength. First, we're going to test cranial nerve 11. So if you can press your hand, your face against my hand and do the opposite side. And if you can shrug your shoulders and if you can push against my arms. Good. Now, if you can just stand, I'll assess your gait. So if you can walk forward and on your way back, walk heel to toe. Good. And if you can just stand, I'm assessing Romberg. Close your eyes. I'm going to be observing you for 20 seconds looking for sway, and I don't see any. So you may take a seat. I'm going to continue assessing for sensory function. So close your eyes, and I'm going to put an object on your hand. Let me know what it is.
Coin.
And another item. What is this one?
Club.
Good. And I'm going to write a letter on your palm. Let me know what it is.
And.
Good. And this time a number.
2.
Good. Now, if you can tell me where you feel the sensation, I'm going to be pressing this on your arms as well as your legs.
Left forearm, right wrist, left shin, right foot.
Good. And now I'm going to assess for alternating movement, your rapid alternating movement, yes. And if you can stroke your heel with the opposite leg, working your way from the knee down to the foot. And rapid alternating movement for the upper and lower extremities are intact. Next, I'm going to check for your deep tendon reflexes. So if you can just let your arm hang, relax. I'm first going to tap on your triceps. Now your, relax, your biceps, and your brachioradialis. Relax. Next, I'm going to check your patellar reflex and your Achilles reflex. And I will also check your pedal pulses. So your dorsalis pedis and your posterior tibialis, and they are 2+. I mentioned 3 words at the beginning of the exam. Do you remember what those 3 words are?
Apple, balloon, chair.
Very good. So that concludes our head-to-toe exam. Do you have any questions for me?
No.
Thank you, Kaylin.